This is Karen.
Hi, everyone. This is Shane.
Today, we're looking at a lesson called Clothes Test. Why are barber poles red, white, and blue? And the vocabulary words are razor.
Razor.
Andy went to the store to buy a razor.
Procedure.
Procedure.
This procedure is very simple.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Basin.
Basin.
Julie filled the basin with water.
Bandage.
Bandage.
Nick asked Stacy if she had any extra bandages.
So we're talking about barbers.
Yeah, barber poles to be specific.
That's right.
Why? Did you ever wonder about this? Why are barber poles red, white, and blue?
No, actually, that question has never came to my mind.
I had thought about it before, really.
Oh, yeah, really?
I thought, okay. It's so weird. Really, why do they have this pole always outside of a barber shop?
And it's red, white, and blue.
Yeah, so.
Okay, so today's.
It's kind of creepy, the reason why.
I know it is. So today's lesson, we're going to explain why and where it came from, right?
So the white is because of bandages. Now, these bandages were used because of something called bloodletting.
What is bloodletting?
So it's kind of a therapy to try to cure an illness by cutting someone and letting blood flow out of them to get rid of diseases or sickness or maybe evil spirits or something.
So what you're saying is that these barbershops, not only do they help you shave and help you do your hair, they also perform this procedure called bloodletting.
Yes, and they would use bandages and they would take these white bandages outside and put them around a basically a pole.
Okay.
And then people would know that they also would do bloodletting at this barber shop.
The red would represent blood and the white would represent bandage.
And then eventually this went to America. And they're not really positive why blue, but think about it. American flag, red, white, and blue. So they might have added blue to the color for that.
But maybe now, that's why.
That's the tradition everywhere. It's red, white, and blue.
Interesting
and kind of scary.
I know, bloodletting.
Right.
I never knew that.
Let's learn more.
Okay, enjoy.
Enjoy.
Why are barber poles red, white, and blue? A rotating pole with red, white, and sometimes blue stripes is a common sight outside barber shops. But do you know why these specific colors were chosen? The answer lies in the history of the barber shop. In the Middle Ages, people didn't just go there to get their hair cut. They also went to do bloodletting because barbers had experience with razors.
Hi, I'm Jeff.
Hi, I'm Henny.
Welcome to this month's clothes test lesson. Today, we'll be reading about barber poles and the color of barber poles. Now, I know that this sounds boring, but bear with us. This topic is more interesting than you might think.
Indeed. Okay, the title of our article is, Why are barber poles red, white, and blue? Okay, let's get started.
The first line of today's lesson says, A rotating pole with red, white, and sometimes blue stripes is a common sight outside barber shops. Yes, this rotating pole, by the way, that's a barber pole.
好，同学们有没有注意过理发店外面常常会有一只红白相间的这个旋转柱，有的是红白蓝三种颜色条纹的旋转柱。那我们今天的课文就是要看看理发店这个三色灯的由来。好，那这边有几个补充单字 ，rotate 这个动词它表示转动、旋转，那通常是指围绕着一个固定的点去旋转。那么 stripe 它是指条纹，还有 barber shop 就是指理发店。Okay, red, white, and sometimes blue. These are the colors you commonly find on barber poles. But do you know why these specific colors were chosen? Well, I for one do not.
Me neither. But never fear. We're going to start to answer this question right now.
Right. The answer, the history of the barber shop.
Your options are A, lays in, B, lies in, C, sits on, or D, stands for.
好，题目的意思是答案就空格理发店的历史当中。那这题是在考我们片语动词的用法。先来看选项 A， lays in 表示储藏储备。那么 B， lies in 表示问题啊、解决方法或是原因等等就在于什么，存在于什么什么。那么 C， sit on 它表示拖延或是搁置不处理。D stands for， 它有代表象征的意思。那根据课文，它应该是要表达答案就在理发店的历史当中，答案就存在于历史当中。所以这题最适合的选项是 B lies in。So the sentence should read:
The answer lies in the history of the barber shop.
Well, I get it. If we learn a little bit about barber shops and their history.We'll also learn why barber poles are colored in the way they are.
There you go. Okay, let's start learning the history of the barber shop. The next line in our article says, In the Middle Ages, people didn't just go there to get their hair. Your options are A, cut, B, cuts, C, to cut, or D, cutting.
好，题目的意思是在中世纪，人们不只到那里去剪头发。那这题是来考我们动词 get 的用法。get 在这边它表示使或是让，意思就跟使役动词 have 是一样的，可以用来表达安排人做某事、请人做某事。那么用法是 get 加受词加过去分词。例如 ，Dave got his car washed yesterday， 也可以说 Dave had his car washed yesterday。Dave 昨天请人家洗他的车，那因为受词是车子，所以用过去分词 washed 来当受词补语，补充说明车子是被别人洗。好，那么课文里面的受词是 their hair， 他们的头发，那是要表达说请人剪头发，所以这个受词补语也是用过去分词来表达被动的语态。好，那么选项里面动词 cut 它三态同形，所以应该说 get their hair cut 表示请人家剪头发。那这题正确答案就要选 A cut。 So the sentence should read
In the Middle Ages, people didn't just go there to get their hair cut.
Well, I think I read about this somewhere. In the Middle Ages, barbers were almost like doctors.
Almost, yeah. Mm-hmm. All barbers weren't really doctors, but they could help with the bloodletting that medieval doctors often prescribed. Yes, in the Middle Ages,People also went to the barber to do bloodletting because barbers had experience with razors. By the way, razor is the first vocabulary word of the day. A razor is a sharp blade. Razors can be used for cutting, but for the most part, razors are used in shaving. Okay, they're used in shaving to cut or to remove hair.From a person's skin. For example, Andy went to the store to buy a razor.
好，课文提到中世纪的人去剪头发的时候，也会做放血疗法，因为理发师他们是有使用剃刀的经验。这还真有趣耶。那我们课文里面的 bloodletting 它是指放血疗法，据说古希腊医学认为人的体液不平衡的时候会导致生病，所以割破血管让血液流出来可以促进健康。好，那我们顺便学一下 vein， V-E-I-N， vein 这个字它表示静脉或是血管。好，那我们先休息一下，待会再回到课文当中。 With that everyone, it is now time for a break, but don't go away, we'll be back soon.
Why are barber poles red, white, and blue? For this procedure, barbers used a staff for the patient to hold onto, a basin to catch blood, and linen bandages. They would store these items outside their barber shop, with the blood-stained bandages twisted around the staff and the basin placed on top. This was also a way for barbers to advertise their services.
Okay, we're back. I think I know where the red comes from. Remember, barbers used to be involved in bloodletting. And blood is red.
Sounds about right to me. But we're still short on details here. So let's read some more about bloodletting. Our article continues by saying, For this procedure, barbers used a staff for the patient to a basin to catch blood and linen bandages. Your options are A, hold back, B, hold down, C, hold on, or D, hold on to.
好，题目的意思是，在这个疗程中，理发师用一根棍棒让患者空格，用水盆接血，还有亚麻绷带。好，那句子里面的 staff 在这边是指棍棒或是杆子 ，linen 则是指亚麻布。那这题它是在考我们跟 hold 有关的偏语动词，选项 A hold back 表示阻碍什么什么的发展或者是抑制 ，B hold down 表示设法保住，像设法保住你的工作之类的 ，C hold on。它是不及物用法，表示继续或是不挂断。好，那这个片语它其实也可以表达紧紧的抓住，不过后面要搭配介系词 to， 也就是选项 D 的用法。Hold on to 表示紧抓住、紧握住。那根据课文，它应该是要表达放血治疗过程中，理发师会拿一根棍棒让患者紧紧握住。所以这题最适合答案要选 D， hold on to。So the sentence should read.
For this procedure, barbers used a staff for the patient to hold on to, a basin to catch blood, and linen bandages.
And here we have some vocabulary to discuss.
Yes, we do. First of all, we have the noun procedure to cover. A procedure is like an operation, okay? Very specifically, a procedure is a well-known and established way of doing something. A procedure has steps, and yes, if you follow these steps, you'll get or you'll produce the outcome that you're looking for. For example, this procedure is very simple.
And next up, we have the noun basin to define. A basin is like a large bowl. It's a container that is often used to hold liquid. For example, Julie filled the basin with water.
Mm-hmm. Okay, the final word of the day is bandage. This word can be used as either a noun or a verb. Let's start with this word being used as a noun. A protective coveringused to cover a cut or a wound is called a bandage. Yes, this word is being used as a noun here. A band-aid, for instance, is a simple bandage. Then let's talk about this word being used as a verb. To bandage someone, let's say, is to wrap or to cover them with a bandage. For example, Nick asked Stacy if she had any extra bandages.
Phew, that was a lot of vocabulary to go through.
I agree. So, hey, let's go ahead and get back into things. Let's get back to bloodletting. Bloodletting, it's a little gross, I know. But if you grin and bear it, if you hang in there, soon you'll know where the red on barber poles comes from. Anyway, there was a staff, a basin,and then some bandages.
Okay, and they, barbers from the Middle Ages, would store these items outside their barber shop with the blood-stained bandages twisted around the staff and the basin placed on top. Whoa, I get it! The staff was the pole and the blood was the red.
There you go, and here's something I would have never guessed. The white,comes from the unstained linen bandages. How cool.
I agree. Okay, barbers in the Middle Ages stored the staff and bloody bandages outside of their shops. They did this in order to store these things.
Mm-hmm. But that's not all. This storing was also a way for barbers to advertise their services.
There you go. Okay, everyone, it is now time to take another break. But don't go away. We'll be back soon.
Why are barber poles red, white, and blue? When it became illegal to display bloodletting equipment, barbers used wooden poles to continue the tradition. They painted them red for blood and white for bandages. Blue was added to poles in the United States, reportedly to either represent veins or match with the colors of the American flag. So the barber pole was born and remains a symbol of barbershops to this day.
Welcome back. Let's get on with things and learn about the blue, the sometimes blue.
Okay, first of all, there's something that you should all know. Bloodletting is gross, and so is bloodletting equipment.
One day, people woke up and said, you know, we shouldn't allow barbers to put their bloodletting equipment outside of their shops because that stuff is just gross. Yeah, people went so far as to make this practice against the law.
Yep, one way or another, the tradition of storing bloodletting equipment outside of barbershops became illegal. And when it became illegal to display bloodletting equipment, barbers used wooden poles to continue the tradition.
Indeed. Yeah, these barbers painted them red for blood and white for bandages.
Okay, that makes sense. But again, here's the question. What about the blue?
Hanny, blue was added to poles in the United States, reportedly to represent veins match with the colors of the American flag. Your options are A, not, but, B, either, or, C, neither, nor, or D, whether, or.
好，题目的意思是，在美国木杆上增加了蓝色。据说蓝色空格代表静脉，空格要和美国国旗的颜色搭配。那这题是来考我们连接词。先来看选项 A， not A but B 是指不是 A 而是 B。好 ，B either A or B， 它表示不是 A 就是 B，A 或 B 的其中一个。那么 C。Neither A nor B, 它是指既不是 A 也不是 B, 两者皆不。那么 D, whether A or B, 它表示不管是 A 还是 B 都怎么样怎么样。好，那我们知道美国的国旗有红、白、蓝三种颜色。那根据课文，它应该是要表达在美国木杆上增加蓝色，不是代表静脉，就是是要跟美国国旗的颜色来搭配。总之，蓝色所代表的意义就是这两者的其中一种，所以最适合答案要选 B, either or. So the sentence should read:
Blue was added to poles in the United States.Reportedly to either represent veins or match with the colors of the American flag. And there you have it, Hanny. That's the best I can do. No one knows the answer to your question for sure, but here are two pretty good explanations for barber pole blue, which is apparently an American thing.
Well, that's all right with me, I guess. Anyway, with that, we've come to today's final sentence. It says, So, the barber pole was born and remains a symbol of barbershops.
Your options are A, at times, B, shortly after, C, to this day, or D, in the meantime.
好，题目的意思是，所以理发店的旋转柱就这样诞生了。而且空格仍然是理发店的象征。那这题是来考我们时间副词片语。先来看选项 A, at times, 它表示有时偶尔。B, shortly after, 表示不久之后或是很快地。C, to this day, 表示到今天到现在。D, in the meantime, 表示与此同时在此期间。好，那根据课文，它应该是要表达三色灯旋转柱呢，到现在都还是理发店的象征，所以最适合答案是 C, to this day. So the sentence should read,
So the barber pole was born and remains a symbol of barbershops to this day.
Okay, folks, with that, we are now done with this month's closed test.
And that means it is time for a break. But don't worry, we'll be back next month.
我真的无言的情绪。
欢迎收看就爱讲英文，我是 Steven，
我是 Kate。
那平常呢我讲一些话 Kate 很容易
无言，
是的，所以今天的英文呢就是特别就是针对的可以让他学习
真的，
对，这些是一些
我等一下一定会唱，就是直接拿来说，
对，这些就是一个表达真的很无言的情绪的英文句子。第一个呢就是 I don't know what to say
I don't know what to say. 我不知道他说什么。
对，这个也可以很适合。可能我今天跟你讲了很多东西，我想听你的意见，但是你真的不知道在当下要说什么，所以、
所以不是负面的。
对对 ，I don't know what to say. 我真的不知道该怎么回你、嗯。对，然后也有一些可能，这个我也有看过，可能有人求婚，然后那个女方会说，I don't know what to say.因为我想讲的是 no，
真的假的？
对啊，
所以你这个时候说这个，不是说你很惊喜的说不出话来，而是说
哦，其实好像也可以。如果他是 I don't know what to say，、
所以是要看你的表情。
跟 I don't know what to say， 就是都知道 yes 还是 no，、
所以还是要看情境跟你的表情。
Okay. 对对，第二个呢，是我今天真的不知道，完全不知道要说什么，
我没有话说了。
对 ，I'm at a loss for words。
I'm at loss for words.
对，就是你的字，你想讲的那些单字都已经丢很远了、你根本迷失，不知道到底放在哪里了。
对，没有字，找不到字了。
对 ，I'm at a loss for words.
I'm at loss for words.
第三呢，也是一个很类似的，跟刚刚第二是一模一样。这个呢是 words fail me.
Words fail me.
对，就是失败 fail 嘛。所以是这些单字已经。
把我打败了，
对，把我打败了，因为我完全不知道到底用哪些单字跟你表达我想讲的东西、
我说不出任何的字，
无言，
对
对 ，words fail me。那第四个呢是 I'm speechless，
I'm speechless。
对，我们知道 speech 就是讲出来的话嘛，那 speechless 是讲不出话的意思，
讲不出话，
我就是完全无言，
哑口无言，
对，
不知道该说什么。
以后就是你就知道怎么回我了，就
I'm speechless。
对，非常好，你也学到了。那我们先进入 live action。 My mom put eggplant and grape together in my lunchbox. Words fail me.
I know, I was speechless at the sight.
She always thinks she is a creative cooker. I'm at a loss for words.
Yeah, if I were you, I wouldn't know what to say either.
D, I don't know what to say. 第二 I'm at a loss for words. 第三 words fail me. 第四 I'm speechless.